Things you don't know about Rowan Atkinson. Hello viewers. How are you? Welcome to Nibir Network. Today we will get to know some interesting facts about Rowan Atkinson, who is mostly as Mr. Bean to all of us. Be sure to subscribe to my channel for future videos. With that said, let's get back to our discussion topic. Rowan Sebastian Atkinson, born January 6, 1955, is an English actor, comedian, and writer. He is best known for his work on the sitcoms Blackadder and Mr. Bean. Atkinson first came to prominence in the BBC's sketch comedy show Not the 9 O'Clock News, receiving the 1981 BAFTA for Best Entertainment Performance, and via his participation in The Secret Policeman's Ball. His other work includes the James Bond film Never Say Never Again, playing a bumbling vicar in Four Weddings and a Funeral, voicing the red-billed hornbill Zazu in The Lion King, and playing jewelry salesman Rufus in Love Actually. He also featured in the BBC sitcom The Thin Blue Line. His work in theatre includes the 2009 West End revival of the musical Oliver. Atkinson was listed in The Observer as one of the 50 funniest actors in British comedy in 2007 and among the top 50 comedians ever, in a 2005 poll of fellow comedians. Throughout his career he has collaborated with screenwriter Richard Curtis and composer Howard Goodall, both of whom he met at the Oxford University Dramatic Society during the 1970s. In addition to his 1981 BAFTA, he received an Olivier Award for his 1981 West End Theatre performance in Rowan Atkinson in Review. He has also had cinematic success with his performances in the Mr. Bean movie adaptations Bean and Mr. Bean's Holiday, and also in the Johnny English film series. He also appears as the titular character in Meg Ray. Enough with intro. Now let's get back to the points. Number 1. He graduated from two universities. Atkinson is a very smart man and graduated from both Newcastle University and Oxford University. He wrote a thesis about self-turning control systems. Number 2. He went to school with Tony Blair. Rowan Atkinson and Britain's ex-Prime Minister, Tony Blair, were schoolmates at Durham Choristers School. The two attended Durham Choristers School at the same time. When he joined the school, Atkinson was 11 years old and Tony Blair was 2 years his senior. According to the school's former headmaster, Canon John Grove, the two boys were quite opposite in their behavior. While Atkinson was shy and kept to himself, Blair was very outgoing and a model pupil who volunteered for everything. Number 3. Rowan Atkinson has a master's degree in electrical engineering from Queen's College, Oxford. After he received his undergraduate degree in electrical engineering, Atkinson continued studying for a master's of science in the same field at Queen's College, Oxford in 1975. His course of study was the same as his father who graduated from there in 1935. He was also made an honorary fellow in 2006. Number 4. Fame found him after appearing on a BBC comedy sketch show. Not the 9 O'Clock News was his big break that got his name known in the industry. Though in the beginning of his career Atkinson appeared in several films and shows, he first rose to fame in the BBC comedy show Not the 9 O'Clock News. Not the 9 O'Clock News was a satirical sketch and show about current news stories, pop culture, comedy sketches, and also contained parody songs, re-edited videos, and spoof television formats. It made use of library clips, usually of politicians, royalty, and celebrities. It was aired on BBC Two as a comic alternative to BBC's 9 O'Clock News. The show also featured and helped launch the careers of three other comedians apart from Atkinson, Pamela Stevenson, Mel Smith, and Griff Rhys-Jones. Number 5. Atkinson loves cars. Like, really loves them. He once said that one of the best moments in his life was getting his Class 1 license to drive a lorry. He now owns an impressive collection which includes an Aston Martin, Honda, Audi, and even an McLaren F1. However, he doesn't like Porsches. I have a problem with Porsches. They're wonderful cars, but I know I could never live with one. Somehow, the typical Porsche people and I wish them no ill are not, I feel, my kind of people. he participated in a racing event put on by the Aston Martin Owners Club at the Croft Racing Circuit driving his Aston Martin V8 Zagato, which he crashed, but was unhurt. Though considered a collector, he stated that I'm not a collector. I don't like the toy cupboard syndrome that causes so many good cars to evaporate. He also stated that he hates Porsche and that I know I could never live with one. Number 6. He sometimes even writes for car magazines. He's a petrol head and writes articles for car magazine. Speaking of vehicles, Atkinson is a self-confessed petrol head. The comedian has a real passion for motors and even writes articles for car magazine so he can share this passion with others. Number 7. Atkinson suffers from a stammer. Atkinson suffers from a stammer, so he uses over-articulation, a technique to overcome problematic consonants, for the B sounds. Atkinson turns his stutter problem into a comic device, because he over-articulates the sound of B, as he did when pronouncing the name Bob, in the episode of Bells in Blackadder 2. He had reportedly experienced trouble because of this problem while at school having conversations with his friends. This fatigued and stressed him out. He overcame his stutter as he started acting and stated that, it comes and goes. I find when I play a character other than myself, the stammering disappears. That may have been some of the inspiration for pursuing the career I did. Number 8. Rowan Atkinson created Mr. Bean. Rowan Atkinson created and wrote Mr. Bean, the British sitcom for which he is so famous, while studying for his master's. While in Oxford, Atkinson was asked during his first term to do a sketch that someone might show at the Oxford Playhouse. However, he did not consider himself a writer, having never written anything before. He had only 48 hours to create something, and inspiration struck him in the form of a strange, surreal, and non-speaking character as he stood in front of his mirror pulling faces. While at Oxford, he also met his writer, Richard Curtis, and composer, Howard Goodall, with whom he would collaborate many times throughout his career. He also received national attention in 1976 for his sketches in the Oxford Review, a comedy group featuring Oxford students, at the Edinburgh Festival Fringe, which is now considered the world's largest arts festival. Number 9. He met his wife on the sets of Blackadder. Atkinson met his ex-wife, Sunetra Satori, on the set of Blackadder, where she worked as a makeup artist and has two children with her, Ben and Lily. Sunetra Sastry was Stephen Fry's makeup artist on the set of Blackadder in 1986. According to Fry, Atkinson one day asked him to swap makeup artists. When Fry asked if he didn't like his own makeup artist, Atkinson replied, "And no, it's not that, she's splendid." In February 1990, Atkinson and Sastry married with Stephen Fry as the best man. Together they had two children, Ben and Lily, and were divorced in 2015 after 25 years of marriage. Number 10. Mr. Bean could have been named after another vegetable. The original name for Mr. Bean was Mr. White. It was then changed to Mr. Cauliflower before settling on Mr. Bean. Mr. Bean's name was not decided upon until after the production of the first program. Before adopting the name Mr. Bean, several other vegetable-based names were considered, but in the end, Mr. Bean was chosen. According to Atkinson, his character was inspired by a character named Monsieur Hulot, who was created by a French comedian and director, Jacques Tati. Just like in the old silent films, the series completely depends on physical comedy, making it easier to understand for people who don't speak English. Number 11. Mr. Bean series has only 14 episodes. Despite being such a popular and much-loved comedy show, the Mr. Bean series has only 14 episodes, each being only 25 minutes long. All the episodes of Mr. Bean were aired over a span of 6 years, between January 1, 1990, to November 15, 1995. Apart from the 14 episodes, the series also had a bonus episode aired on December 15, 1995, called The Best Bits of Mr. Bean. It was a compilation episode in which Mr. Bean goes to his loft on a rainy day and reminisces his old adventures from previous episodes. Number 12. Atkinson holds a lorry driving license. Atkinson holds a Category C and E, formerly Class 1, lorry driving license which he obtained in 1981 because of his fascination with lorries. Apart from getting his license to drive a lorry, Atkinson also used his love for trucks in a very humorous song called I Like Trucking in his show Not the 9 O'Clock News. The song depicts him and his friends enthusiastically singing the song, while keeping score of the number of hedgehogs he crushed under the tires while driving, and a car driver who gets tricked by their antics. Number 13. Mr. Bean in James Bond? Atkinson also played a supporting character in Sean Connery's James Bond movie Never Say Never Again back in 1983. Atkinson played a character called Nigel Small Fawcett, a Foreign Office representative in the Bahamas. When James Bond reaches the Bahamas looking for the villain, Maximilian Largo, played by Klaus Maria Brandauer, Small Fawcett informs him that Largo was heading for Nice, France. Number 14. He earned success in French comedy too. During his earliest appearance as Mr. Bean, Atkinson insisted on performing on a French-speaking program instead of English-speaking ones, to see how his physical comedy would fare on international stage. The show, of course, became a huge success in 245 territories and received a number of international awards. In 1987, one of Mr. Bean's earliest performances was held at the Just for Laughs Comedy Festival in Montreal, Canada. While there, Atkinson insisted on being scheduled to perform to a French-speaking audience rather than English-speaking ones. The festival coordinators could not understand why, but Atkinson's intent was to test his physical comedy to see how well it would work on non-English-speaking audiences. The series received a number of international awards including the Rose d'Or and even inspired an animated spin-off. Number 15. Atkinson once saved a plane from crashing. Atkinson once saved a plane from crashing when the pilot fainted even though he never flew a plane before. He managed to keep the plane in the air until the pilot recovered. In March 2001, Atkinson, his wife Sunitra, and their children Ben and Lily were traveling from the airstrip in Yukindu, Kenya, to Nairobi's Wilson Airport when the incident occurred. The pilot of the Cessna 202 aircraft fainted at the controls and the family could not revive him. So, Atkinson was forced to take control of the plane and was able to keep it flying, saving himself and his family until the pilot recovered later. The pilot was then able to make a safe landing at the airport. Number 16. Atkinson is critical about his religion. In 2005, Atkinson led a group of prominent actors and writers including Stephen Fry and Ian McEwan, opposing the racial and religious hatred bill, arguing it would give overwhelming power to religious groups and undermines freedom of speech. Atkinson is critical when it comes to religion and always sought to stand up against laws that could restrict freedom of expression. Apart from opposing the controversial racial and religious hatred bill, he also supported freedom of speech for homosexuals, and voiced his support for the Reform Section 5 campaign, which aims to reform or repeal laws that state an insult can be grounds for arrest. Number 17. He has a record in Top Gear Show. Top Gear is a British motoring magazine, factual television series, conceived by Jeremy Clarkson and Andy Willman, launched on October 20, 2002. And broadcast in the United Kingdom on BBC Two. The program is a relaunched version of the original 1977 show of the same name, which looks at various motor vehicles, primarily cars. While the original format focused mainly on review of cars, the 2002 version expanded on this with motoring-based challenges, special races, timed laps of notable cars, and celebrity timed laps on a course specially designed for the relaunched program, with its format developing over time to focus on a more quirky, humorous, and sometimes controversial style of presentation. In July 2011, Atkinson appeared as the star in a reasonably priced car on Top Gear. Though he was nervous at first, he topped the leaderboard driving a Kia CD and rounded the highest track at that time. The next year in February, his record was beaten by Matt LeBlanc, who later became the host of the show, by a difference of 0.1 seconds. Number 18. He crashed his car twice and claimed €910,000. Atkinson crashed his McLaren F1 twice and claimed €910,000 insurance for its repair, which is the highest ever recorded in Britain. Atkinson bought his McLaren F1 in 1997 for around £540,000. After crashing the car into a hedge in Oxfordshire in 2011, he claimed £910,000 insurance for it. Unlike cars that have seen much use and damage, Atkinson's McLaren F1 had seen a continued increase in its price after he put it up for sale for £8 million. According to specialist car dealer company Taylor and Crawley, the car was sold for an undisclosed amount to a British buyer who will drive it like Rowan did. Number 19. He was awarded the CBE. He was awarded the CBE, Commander of the Order of the British Empire, in the 2013 Queen's Birthday Honours List for his services to drama and charity. As Johnny English, Atkinson already had several encounters with the fictional version of Queen Elizabeth II, always by accident, once even hitting her with a tray while fighting with a ninja pretending to be the Queen. While meeting the real Queen in real life, he chose much less eventful circumstances as he left after the ceremony without talking to the press. His friend from Blackadder, Tony Robinson, also received a knighthood for his public and political services during the ceremony. Number 20. His net worth is $130 million. During his prolific acting career, Atkinson earned a significant amount of money. His current net worth is about £85 million, approximately $130 million. Atkinson's net worth proves how successful an actor he is, considering he doesn't have a very long list of filmography. Mr. Bean and Johnny English are his highest earning works with a total gross income of $618 million at the box office. In the recent years, he received $16 million from his company Hindmech. He also received more income in the form of his McLaren F1's sale at a market value of $12 million. He also owns several properties in London and other countries. Number 21. He celebrated the 25th anniversary of Mr. Bean by riding his iconic mini car. In 2013, he celebrated the 25th anniversary of Mr. Bean by riding his iconic mini around the Buckingham Palace in London. The 25th anniversary sketch is similar to one of his previous episodes called Do It Yourself Mr. Bean. In a similar fashion, as he did in that episode, Atkinson, 60 years old by then, went to enjoy the sights around the Buckingham Palace as Mr. Bean on his iconic car, a 1976 British Leyland Mini 1000. All of Mr. Bean's possessions were packed into the car and his chair tied to the roof. He was accompanied by his favorite precious teddy and posed with a celebratory cake for the fans who had gathered around. Number 22. Director Richard Curtis developed Mr. Bean with Rowan Atkinson. Love Actually director Richard Curtis developed Mr. Bean with Rowan Atkinson. Atkinson's creative partner at the time, and the man who helped develop the character of Mr. Bean, was writer-director, as well as producer, Richard Curtis. The two collaborated on Not the 9 O'Clock News and Blackadder before Mr. Bean ever hit the airwaves. Curtis would later make the jump to the big screen as the writer of Four Weddings and a Funeral, Notting Hill, and Bridget Jones's Diary, and the writer-director of Love Actually, The Boat That Rocked, and About Time. Which explains Atkinson's cameo in Love Actually. Number 23. Rowan Atkinson was inspired by Jacques Tati. Over the years, Atkinson has repeatedly cited French comedian Jacques Tati as one of the great influences on Mr. Bean. My interest in physical comedy was from discovering a film by Jacques Tati called Mr. Hulot's Holiday, Atkinson says in The Story of Bean. It just struck a chord with me. I so admired it, because it was an uncompromising comic attitude and setting that I really admired. Number 24. Mr. Bean is the man who likes toilets. Mr. Bean doesn't speak often, but when he does, the voice he uses is the same one Atkinson used to voice, the man who likes toilets, sketch on Not the 9 O'Clock News. Number 25. Rowan Atkinson thinks Mr. Bean is an anarchist. Atkinson often refers to the character of Mr. Bean as a child in a grown man's body. And in a 2003 interview with IGN, he called him sort of such a natural anarchist. But at the same time, Mr. Bean is a very, very self-contained character because he's so sort of introspective and so selfish and self-centered that there's no particular need to have another person in the scene to make him funny. Number 26. Rowan Atkinson really can wiggle his ears. Mr. Bean's legendary ear wiggle is one trait Atkinson has in common with his on-screen alter ego. While promoting Mr. Bean's holiday, ABC's David Stratton asked perhaps the most crucial question of the entire interview, "Can you really wiggle your ears?" To which Atkinson simply replied, "Yes, I can." Number 27. Mr. Bean performed at the Olympics. When London hosted the Summer Olympics in 2012, Mr. Bean was on hand for the opening ceremony, where he ushered in the games with a rendition of Chariots of Fire. Number 28. Rowan Atkinson retired the role in late 2012. In an interview with The Telegraph in November of 2012, Atkinson admitted that Mr. Bean's time was coming to an end. "The stuff that has been most commercially successful for me basically quite physical, quite childish, I increasingly feel I'm going to do a lot less of," Atkinson said. "Apart from the fact that your physical ability starts to decline, I also think someone in their 50s being childlike becomes a little sad. You've got to be careful." Number 29. Mr. Bean's creators could not have predicted its success. When asked about Mr. Bean's enduring appeal during a BBC World Service radio interview, executive producer Peter Bennett Jones said, "I don't think anyone could have anticipated quite how successful and long-lived it would be. Coming up to 25 years is an extraordinary thought since we first went on air on January 1, 1990. Mr. Bean's been very good to us all, so we love Mr. Bean." Number 30. He was one of the guests at Prince William and Kate Middleton's wedding. Rowan Atkinson was invited in the wedding of Prince William and Kate Middleton back in April 2011. He's good friends with Prince Charles and Camilla. Atkinson definitely has some friends in high places. He's actually one of the few celebrity guests who were invited to attend the wedding of Prince Charles and Camilla Parker Knowles. Atkinson has also done a lot of charitable work for the Prince's Trust, which might help explain the connection. Number 31. He was one of only three actors to appear in every series of Blackadder. Rowan Atkinson was actually one of only three actors who appeared in all four series of Blackadder, the others being Tony Robinson and Tim McInerney. Number 32. He used his own Aston Martin in Johnny English. In Johnny English, Rowan Atkinson used his own Aston Martin DB7 Vantage in the film, a powerful and expensive car. Number 33. He wasn't a fan of the first Blackadder series. Atkinson was not a fan of the first Blackadder series, and he nearly pushed to have any future series cancelled. Thank goodness he didn't. The show went on to become one of Britain's best-loved sitcoms. Number 34. He was the voice of one of the key characters in The Lion King. He played Zazu, the smart-mouth red-billed hornbill. And you guessed it right, he is the one singing "I Just Can't Wait to Be King." Number 35. So what led to Rowan being cast as Mr. Bean? It all began when he was getting his master's degree at Oxford University. He was invited to do a comedy sketch at the Playhouse, and the idea for the character appeared in his head when he was fooling around in front of the mirror with strange facial expressions. In his own words, this strange, surreal, sort of non-speaking character evolved. Number 36. His daughter is also an actress. Rowan's daughter, Lily, had a part in the movie Mr. Bean's Holiday. Number 37. He was really quiet on his first date. Apparently, he was really quiet on his first date with his ex-wife. The only thing he said was "pass the ketchup" when they went out to dinner. Number 38. He is the funniest actor of all time. He has been listed in The Observer for the top 50 funniest British actors. Number 39. Atkinson doesn't really know what his face looks like. "I've hardly ever looked at my face. I hope it's doing what I think it's doing," says the Mr. Bean actor. He just kind of puts his faith in what he's doing and hopes for the best. When he hears the laughter, he knows it's working. Number 40. His divorce cost him $30 million. He fought neighbors and planners for a decade to build this £10 million ultra-modern home in the Cotswolds. Now it appears Rowan Atkinson has given up the controversial property to his ex-wife after leaving her for a younger woman. The Mr. Bean star is believed to have forfeited the Oxfordshire mansion as part of a divorce settlement with former BBC makeup artist Sunetra Sastry, 55. Meanwhile, Atkinson, 63, is living with his new love, 34-year-old actress Louise Ford, and their new baby in his £5 million property in Hampstead, North London. The modernist Cotswolds estate, filled with high gadgets, comes with an underground garage for the Blackadder star's fleet of supercars. Although locals dubbed it a space-age petrol station, it has won a top architecture award. Friends said they were surprised Atkinson was willing to give it up, his life's work, when he ended his 24-year marriage to Miss Sastry in 2016. Thanks for watching. If you like the video, please subscribe to my channel, hit the like button below, and please don't forget to share this video with your friends.